King is standing in the way of Duggan.
No, he's not. There's plenty of room for Duggan to go around him.
Welcome to another edition of Pro Wrestling This Week. I'm Joe Pedicino.
And I'm Gordon Solie. This week on PWTW, Jim Duggan attempts to dethrone a king. Our international match comes from San Juan, Puerto Rico. We'll be seeing action from world-class championship wrestling from Portland, Oregon. Our feature match is from the continental area. And Joe, it all starts off, of course, with Chris Adams returning to the WCCW.
That's right. In the world-class area, Chris Adams, a former world champion, has returned, and he says he's back to do battle. He's at ringside as we go to this match now between Brian Adias and his arch-nemesis, Kevin Von Erich.
With the arm and the body, throws Brian into the opposite corner. Kevin has several options now. He charges, and Brian is out of the way. Kevin really hit hard.
He saw that Kevin has his leg, he's going after the weakest spot possible. I think Brian Adias is very, very, he's pulling out to anything he can get right now. He knows he's in trouble.
He has hugged Kevin in the rope, and Kerry, who got up to cheer Kevin on,
he's getting in.
Gets nailed by Brian, and now Kerry's in on Adias. Look out, a
discus punch! This is just like old times, Mark. This is great.
Kevin Von Erich just discus punch Brian Adias all the way out of the ring.
What's going on?
Hurry up.
Okay.
What are you trying to do here?
This is the strongest bench press in the world.
Shame on you. The strongest man right here. What are you? You're wearing yellow. You call yourself the Modern Day Warrior.
Adias has been hiding. Here he comes. And with the cast, he hits Kevin from behind. And we got that one in the ring.
Okay, this is a brawl. I tell you what, if Kerry doesn't do something, I'm going to go in the ring in a minute. I cannot stand by. Kerry doesn't need any help, Mark. Look at this. Kerry has just slammed the strongest man in the world. And who says Kerry Von Erich cannot come up? Kerry is better than ever.
Kevin nails Pringle. Kerry gives Arcidi the discus. Look out, Pringle. Double dropkick. Look at this crowd, ladies and gentlemen. And look at Pringle.
Mark, this is fantastic. Kerry Von Erich is back. This makes me feel good. This makes me really feel at home.
Pro Wrestling This Week, as we now move on to the Kansas City area, Gordon.
You know, Joe, the wrestling fans, or a lot of them in the Kansas City area right now, are very, very disappointed in the Batten Twins. I'm referring, of course, to Brad and Bart Batten. They have joined forces with Downtown Bruno. We're going to see them in an Australian tag team match against Chief Joe Lightfoot and Jerry Anderson. Previous to this match, however, Rick McCord came out and tried to talk to the Battens. They jumped him, beat him up so badly that he was unable to continue or compete in a television championship match. But right now, let's watch the Batten brothers in action.
This particular putt, it looks like the Batten twins could pin this man almost at any time. Ah, oh, great, all right, great sportsmanship,
hey,
Bruno.
I told him to hurt this guy. Don't just beat him, humiliate him, make him suffer. Make an example out of this guy, brother. Make an example out of him. So all... Make an example out of them. Show everybody exactly how great the Batten Twins are. Oh, yeah, the greatest tag team in professional wrestling.
People used to know how great the Batten Twins are when they had sportsmanship.
Oh, ho, ho, ho. Sportsmanship. What's that, huh? This is America.
What about the support of the people?
This is 1987, not 1937. We're not worried about the support of the people. What do these people do for us? They make me sick, these people. They're a bunch of stinking dirt farmers. We're champions.
Well, Jerry Anderson, the dirt farmer, as you call him, managed to fight his way back up on his feet.
Not for long. Where's he at now? Tell me. Tell me. Tell all the people. Tell them. Tell them. Where's he at? He's on his back. He's suffering. He's kicking. He wishes he was anywhere but right here because he's being humiliated in front of all his farmer friends, in front of all his bucktooth friends, see?
Apparently, the Batten twins decided to make an example.
No, downtown Blue decided that they would make an example. Uh-huh. That's what it is. Watch this. Watch this.
Batten, a very, very unique maneuver.
Oh, come on!
Batten now clamping down with a version of the sleeper. On Jerry Anderson. Anderson's out on his feet. And I can't understand why they don't go ahead and beat this guy like true gentlemen do.
Wait a minute. Who's saying about being a gentleman? Let me tell
well,
you
apparently
something.
Apparently not if they're with you.
When I go back to Nashville, Tennessee, and I walk downtown on Lower Broad, the people come up to me and they say, you used to be a bum, you used to be a street urchin, now you're J. Paul Ghetto. That's what downtown Bruno is, the man with the money.
Double leg dive, clothesline off the top on Jerry Anderson.
Oh, yeah. Other guy didn't even have to got
you.
By the way, the Battens are the Central States Tag Team Champions. Speaking about champions, there are going to be a lot of champions on that cruise upcoming February 7th.
That's true, Gordon. You know, one of the things that everybody tells us they're looking forward to is the championship trivia tournament where we will crown the first world's champion of wrestling trivia, of course, using the Gordon Solie Wrestling Championship Trivia game that's now available. And as a matter of fact, I got a letter just this week from a gentleman who was very, very enthusiastic about his plans for the cruise. He has booked a room on the cruise and said one of the things he was the most excited about was the lady wrestlers we were going to have there. Wendy Richter will be there along with a couple of the other lady wrestlers. Of course, Bruiser Brody is going to be on the cruise with us. Jerry the King Lawler will be there. The Missing Link is going to be there. Red Bastien, Ken Mantell. And, of course, Paul E. Dangerously will be there. He has, in fact, booked a whole suite of rooms. And there's no telling who he will have along with him. And I want to make sure, as a matter of fact, such a nice letter that we got from a fellow in Pittsburgh, that we're going to show it to Bruiser Brody, and I'm sure he'll like to meet this fellow.
I'm sure he will indeed. Cruise begins on February 7th. If you want more information about it, it takes off from Miami, goes to Nassau, St. Thomas, and San Juan. The number to call for information on the Great Escapes travel and our dream cruise is 714-592-5608. We're looking forward to seeing you on that cruise. Joe, what's happening now in the AWA?
Well, Gordon, we're going to be moving to the American Wrestling Association now. We've got a TV title tournament match. You know, they're running a TV tournament there on a point system. And right now, we're going to see Kevin Kelly, Mr. Magnificent, as he goes up against the big crusher, Jerry Blackwell.
Oh, what power! Huh. What power! Here comes Kelly again with an elbow. And now the hook of the leg and the cover.
Oh, I'm going to tell you, that hurt Jerry Blackwell. I don't believe I have ever seen him slam before, Rod.
A double switch to the back by Mr. Magnificent. What a war is going on right here on the shores of the Showboat in Las Vegas, Nevada. Listen to the crowd. It's hand-to-hand combat. Blackwell is cut on the forehead.
You can't tell this Mr. Magnificent Kevin Kelly short either, I'll tell you. He is one powerful man.
Look at this. Oh! A Blackwell clothesline.
Uh-oh.
Here's Kaminsky. Brought into the ring by Blackwell. Headbutt by Blackwell. And now, hello there.
They are going to get disqualified, I'll guarantee you.
Blackwell hammering away, and Kaminsky, here comes Killer Kelly from behind with a knee into the kidneys and a smash behind the head. And now it is both Kaminsky and Kelly on Blackwell. And this has got to be stopped.
They have been disqualified. The bell was rang. Uh-oh. Here comes Joey Blackwell back down. I'll tell you what, Dick Kaminsky must have felt that Kevin Kelly had all he could handle.
Here comes referee Bob Warren. Come here, Bob. What? He threw the match out. He threw the match out.
One would have to say that the referee certainly took proper action in that match.
That's right. It was just almost out of hand with the interference and everything that we've got there. Speaking of interference, the king of the interference is coming your way now. Paulie Dangerously in the danger zone. He's got JT Southern with him this week.
I'm on the air. I'll get back to you. Okay, fine. Hi. Once again, it's the Danger Zone. As you know, I'm Paulie Dangerously. My guest this week, one half of the initial shock, JT Southern. And as we film this, just 24 hours from now, JT and his partner, DJ Peterson. I get your names kind of confused once in a while. You know, it's kind of confusing. Anyway, this guy and his partner will take on my original Midnight Express, Loverboy Dennis and Ravishing Randy, in Las Vegas on ESPN. Nationwide cable for the right to face the Russians for the AWA World Tag Team Championships. And if you just hold on a minute, JT, I have a point to make here. And as everybody knows, I am going on that cruise. Whether Pedicino or Sully or RP himself likes it or not, I'm going to be there for that cruise. And you know, I was at the newsstand just about a week ago and I saw my pal Donald Trump on the cover of Newsweek. I like Don's attitude, you know. What I can't win, I'll buy. And my attitude is, what I can't buy, I'll steal. But you see, I don't have to steal a ticket for that cruise, man, because I bought the presidential suite. And we're going to have a danger zone there. Oh, yes, we are. You can bring on the people from Glasgow, Scotland. I'm going to be there. I'm going to be on that boat. And I'm going to take apart each and every person that wants to make a fool of Paulie Dangerously in the danger zone. And JT, now you want something to say to these people? Go right ahead, say something.
Yeah,
hold it. We're out of time.
Can I write my favorites of the World Wrestling Council, like TNT and Carlos Colon?
To the WWF and in the World Wrestling Federation, of course, the big event coming up soon will be the Survivor Series, coming up Thanksgiving night, 7:30 on your local pay-per-view cable, exclusively on pay-per-view. Let's go now to our friend Craig DeGeorge with the WWF and this exclusive update on the Tag Team Survivor match.
Teams of five will strive to survive in the first ever World Wrestling Federation Survivor Series. Hello again, everyone. The date is fast approaching. What a Thanksgiving night it's going to be. Thursday evening, November the 26th at 7:30, the World Wrestling Federation presents its Survivor Series, a pay-per-view cable exclusive. There will be over 45 wrestlers involved on teams in four different categories. There'll be a ladies division and two singles division, wherein one, Hulk Hogan will manage a team against Andre the Giant's team, and it very well could be that Hulk Hogan meets Andre the Giant to decide that competition. But for now, our focus is on the tag team division. The World Wrestling Federation champions, the Hart Foundation, will manage one team. On the other side, Strike Force will manage a team. Here are the lineups. For Strike Force, they'll be led by the British Bulldogs, the Dynamite Kid, and Davey Boy Smith. Also, Jacques and Raymond, the Rougeau brothers. Powers and Roma, the Young Stallions. and Jumping Jim Brunzel, and B. Brian Blair, the Killer Bees. For the Hart Foundation, they'll have the Dream Team, Dino Bravo and Greg the Hammer Valentine, the Bolsheviks, Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov, the Islanders, Haku and Tama, and Demolition, Axe and Smash. And Mr. Fuji's awesome duo is coming on lately. Demolition could indeed prove to be the spoilers of that tag team division. Let's check out some recent action of theirs. Say.
What's going to happen here?
Ooh, look at the strength.
Oh, my. Drives the knee home. Tag made again. Well, he's Demolition. Uh-oh, what's this?
Okay.
Look out. Axe. Drove the elbow. Whoa. It's all over.
As you might expect, a very competitive tag team division with the 10 best teams in the World Wrestling Federation. The Survivor Series, where teams of five will strive to survive. And for more information on this pay-per-view spectacular, contact your local cable operator and ask for the World Wrestling Federation Survivor Series. With this update, I'm Craig DeGeorge.
Well, I can see control being a problem with that many competitors all the way around the ring in the Survivor Series. And evidence of that was by the opening bit of our program, Joe, and we saw the situation already erupting between Jim Duggan and Harley Race.
That's right. You know, these two evidently are not going to get along. And as a matter of fact, they're on opposing teams in the Survivor Series, so they may come head-to-head there in the Survivor Series. Let's go take a look at an incident this week that happened between Jim Duggan and the King, Harley Race.
Tiger Chun-Li on his way out, and Duggan has in his hand at 2x4. And look at the King. The King is not armed with anything. He's looking for Bobby Heenan. That's what he's looking for. Here comes a chair. Oh, now it's even. Oh, boy. Get hurt. Let's maintain. Get him out of there. Get him out of there. Harley Race wants to get back in there. Get him back. Let's get the official word. Uh-oh. What's going to happen here? You got to be kidding me.
Well, a king is dethroned. Or is he? Perhaps the Survivor Series will tell. Time now for Sound Off with the lovely Boni Blackstone. And she has a lot of advice as to how to write the World Wrestling Council, some comments about Arn Anderson, and where is Sergeant Slaughter? Boni?
Paul C. of Huntsville, Alabama, watching pro wrestling this week on WDZX Channel 54, asks, how can I write my favorites of the World Wrestling Council, like TNT and Carlos Colon? Well, Paul, you'll need the address. So write to World Wrestling Council, Box 8900, Santurce, Puerto Rico, 00910. And just listen to this. Julia H. of Miami, Florida, watching WDZL Channel 39, says Arn Anderson is a traitor. To go against blood for friendship is a big no-no. Arn Anderson, you will never be anything, and it's because of your turncoat attitude. Let's face it, you don't even deserve a title. The Four Horsemen keep you around as an enforcer. Your brother Ole got smart. He got tired of being used and got out. And Mary W. of Savannah, Georgia, watching us on WTGS Channel 28, wants to know, where is Sergeant Slaughter? After taking time off to pursue his movie and acting career, Sergeant Slaughter has returned to the ring wars in the AWA and NWF. The Sergeant can be seen in the G.I. Joe cartoon series, and also, we're happy to say, right here on Pro Wrestling This Week. Thanks for your question, Julia. I'm Boni Blackstone, and this has been Sound Off.
Well, thank you very much, Boni, for that input from our viewers. Right now, it's time to go to Portland, Oregon, and it starts out as a six-man tag team match, but it doesn't stay that way for long. The Grappler, Moondog Moretti, and the Super Ninja on one team, Mike Miller, Coco Samoa, and the Avalanche on the other. Watch what happens.
Well, you folks over in Astoria, you can't make it to the Portland Sports Arena. The American Legion Post, what is that, 4? 12. American Legion Post 12 is going to have a big Halloween party, and Ramblin' Rod's going to be there. You recognize
him? And the kids
him?
Are admitted free to that one.
Yeah.
There's a leg on elbow smash right across the chest of Mike Miller. Grappler held him. Boy, they're really working Miller over.
Miller has really been taking the beating.
It'll show you the resiliency of Miller. They're not taking any chances. They're going to try to wear him down so bad he can't breathe.
That's a reversal.
Oh, baby!
What a clothesline that was! That came from downtown Philadelphia!
Oh, man! I think they both hung each other out to dry on that one. Super
Miller's
Ninja.
Miller's trying to get us. He's tagged! Coco Samoa, in comes the big Samoan. Right hand, left hand, down goes the Grappler. He puts a Coco headbutt on Moretti.
Oh.
Big right hand, Ninja. The Grappler's running for cover, takes a shot at Mike Miller.
Miller's out on the floor. And there's too many people. There's just too many in there. Against Coco.
Yeah, in the middle of all this, here comes young Art Barr.
He's back there, Dutch. He's groggy, but he's watching the monitor. He's coherent at the
time.
Uh-oh. All right, that's good.
Art, you better get out there.
There's Sandy Barr. Has just been knocked out by a tackle.
Here comes Avalanche.
The Avalanche. Look
at Avalanche is in. Oh, man. Avalanche leveled Grappler.
Savage is coming back. He's too
slow. Avalanche is cleaning house. No.
Look out, here comes a shoulder blow.
Oh, man.
Oh, God, upside down, the Ninja.
Did you see him hit it?
I think he busted his ribs.
Here's another one.
Look at that. They're going to throw the Grappler into him. Here comes the best shot of the night.
Here comes the Grappler.
Set, hut one, hut two, hut three.
Here it is.
Boom.
Oh, he's taken out of the play. Yeah.
Look at this.
Flip-flopping from team to team. Well, the RPMs go up against the Nasty Boys, and let's see what happens this week, and then watch the challenge that follows.
As Tommy Lane covers one, two, but that's all they could get out of him.
Boy, at the last instant, looked like it took every ounce of strength that Jerry Sag had. He was able to kick and get out of the count of three.
Boy, if he doesn't get to the corner soon and get some relief in there from Brian Knobbs, I think about one more major pin effort might do it in, Dave, and we'll have new champions.
Rock and roll RPMs determined to see that happens. They're trying to keep Sag away from the corner. Sag battling back now. He's closer to the corner.
Yes.
He needs to go for the tag. He turned the wrong way. A leap to the corner and a tag on Brian Knobbs is the best move. He hasn't done it. Brian Knobbs comes in without a tag. He grabs Mike Davis. Well, that's one way to get him out of there. Look out, down here on the floor. Knobbs and Davis in the ring. Tommy Lane has just hit Jerry Sag with something. He went to the tights, had something in his fist, and unloaded on Jerry Sag. Here's a count of two and three. We've got new champions.
Well, if we can get back to the bell, we'll ring the bell because, as David says, we got a 1-2-3, and we have new Southern Tag Champions.
Nothing but low-life cowards that keep those guys out of the belt. Nothing but cowards. They want to fight. Let's do it right now.
Hey, there's another way to handle these guys. I can understand they've been talking all hour about the whole thing.
You ain't gonna
have. Come on, you big idiot.
2 minutes.
Two minutes. A bunch of talkers. All you want to do is stand out here and talk. You guys, you ain't gonna fight.
Jeff Jarrett, Billy Travis heading out of here as they determine, and right away coming after Jarrett and Travis, Mike Davis with a chair slams both of them. You notice they waited until the back was turned before they ever took off after him. Travis thrown into Tommy Lane, and look at, come on, Mike. Well, he put the chair down. That's the only thing I can say for him in there. As he clubbed Jeff with it. Knuckles him down on the floor. And now the Rock and Roll RPMs, who pick their time to make the run at Jarrett and Travis. Mike Davis with Jeff Jarrett and Tommy Lane with Billy Travis. Over the desk goes Jeff. Come on, Mike.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt now about Mike Davis and Tommy Lane and the backstabbers that they've become. And I think we should watch for a real war in the Memphis area between Jarrett and Travis and the Rock and Roll RPMs. Right now, we're going to New York City and the offices of PWI for our Pro Wrestling Illustrated report with Craig Peters. We've got ratings this week and some information on the 87 Achievement Awards.
This is Craig Peters, managing editor of Pro Wrestling Illustrated magazine. Bill Apt is on special assignment, but get a pencil because I'll be giving you a chance to vote for some of the most important awards in wrestling. But first, let's take a look at the ratings for the World Wrestling Council. And now let's take a look at PWI's top 10 most hated list. It's that time of the year again. The Pro Wrestling Illustrated Achievement 87 Awards are coming around, and this is your opportunity to vote for the winners in what has become the most important fan poll in professional wrestling. The Pro Wrestling Illustrated Achievement Awards are like the Academy Awards for movies, the Emmys for television. They really are the most respected by the wrestlers and by the fans. And what we would like you to do is cast your votes in the following 10 categories. Rookie of the Year, Inspirational Wrestler of the Year, the Most Improved Wrestler of the Year, Manager of the Year, Feud of the Year, Most Popular Wrestler of the Year, Most Hated Wrestler of the Year, Match of the Year, Tag Team of the Year, and Wrestler of the Year. Now you can send your ballot to Pro Wrestling Illustrated, Box 48, Rockville Center, New York, 11571. Also, if you'd like to pick up a copy of the January 1988 issue of Pro Wrestling Illustrated, now on sale, there's a ballot in there. Or you could send a self-addressed stamped envelope to the address I just mentioned, and we'll send you a ballot ourselves. But the important thing is, cast your vote, because these awards are the most respected in the sport, and your vote counts. The Raptor will be back next time. I'm Craig Peters. We'll see you again.
Our international match this week takes place in San Juan, Puerto Rico, which, by the way, Joe, will be one of our ports of call, of course, during the wrestling fans' dream cruise from February 7th until the 14th. We're going to see
Have we mentioned that includes 56 meals lately?
Yeah, you're right. 56 meals and a three-month payment plan. All those good things are available, plus some great matches in San Juan one night.
That's right. You know, on Wednesday night of the cruise, we'll be in San Juan, Puerto Rico, and this is the type match we'll be seeing at a big international TV taping. This is a scaffold match high above the ring. El Gran Mendoza taking on Hercules Castilla Jr.
Come on, there's not a place to hang on from. Mendoza, he's scared. If Castillo's scared, he's not showing it right now. Let's see what happens here. Both men look at each other. The moment of truth has come. In midair, the scaffold, the Skywalkers of professional wrestling. The first match held in scaffold was held in San Antonio, Texas. The second match ever held in scaffold was held here in Puerto Rico. And as I understand, then came another situation in the NWA in the States with its scaffold called the Skywalkers. But the first match took place in San Antonio, Texas. Here, Hurricane hanging in top. Almost pushing off the challenger. He's gonna go down 20 feet if he falls from there. Not a place to grab on from. Castillo kicking him on the head. Mendoza hanging on for his dear life. Oh, what a move by Mendoza, hooking the leg and going on top of Castillo.
We will continue with our international match right after we pause for this commercial timeout.
Has him up. Double duty pile driver. And that may be all she wrote right here and
ringside with the powerful women of wrestling. Saturday night at 7 on TV 58.
More great action now on Pro Wrestling This Week, Gordon.
Our international match this week, of course, is a scaffold match from San Juan, Puerto Rico. El Gran Mendoza going up against Hurricane Castillo Jr. Obviously, this match is in progress.
Mendoza trying to push Castillo. What a match, ladies and gentlemen, for the world's title. Junior heavyweight title, the professor, the manager of Mendoza, urging his wrestler to throw off Castillo. He wants the title back. No question about it. Castillo in trouble. I don't think he's going to be able to get back into the scaffold. Mendoza's got him in control. The professor is worried. Castillo holding on, and the professor wants the title right now. Look out! Castillo pushing off on Mendoza. Now both men are holding on. The Skywalkers hanging. Look at this move. Wow. Using the legs. And we have seen the victory. Mendoza has been thrown off the scaffold. What a battle. What a matchup.
You know, Joe, it's interesting to note that Wildcat Wendell Cooley has been having a problem, an identity crisis, if you will, of late in the Continental area.
That's right. Just a few weeks ago, we saw him say that he was quitting wrestling.
Yep.
A big surprise this week, though, in the Continental area. Actually, it was a tag team match with Fuller and Golden going up against the Masked Avengers. But take a look at the turn of events.
The Avenger helping the other one out of the ring. So it looks like it is all over. Of course, the bell had never rung. Wait a minute. Wait a minute, who is this? Who is this? Danny Davis just came into the ring, and apparently he wants to take on Fuller and Golden. And that's much to everybody's pleasure here in Montgomery. Danny Davis is saying, okay, let's go for it. And the referee over there double-checking now. Well, I never did hear that bell ring, but they took off after the Avengers. All right, wait a second. All right, there comes the one Avenger back. So we have a tag team once again. They quickly double team on the Avenger. They're setting him up for another pile driver. And so the Avenger, in a world of hurt here, the Avenger outside the ring, victim of the pile driver. And that leaves Danny Davis alone against two opponents. Wait a minute, what do we got here now? We have another Avenger. Apparently we have another Avenger removing this one. Danny Davis, in the meantime, is in dire straits. As they are double-teaming him, Fuller and Golden have Danny Davis in a lot of trouble. Hold on a second. Here comes apparently another Avenger, and he's saying, tag up. absolutely berserk now on the team of Fuller and Golden. He smashes their heads together like a couple of grapes. Now we've got all four of them in there. Davis dumped from the ring. Wait a minute. Tried to get him in a rolling reverse. Davis catches him. The Avenger catches Golden. The Avenger catches Golden. The Avenger and Danny Davis have just turned back. Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden. And you can see a very, very happy crowd here at the Montgomery Civic Center. And wait a minute. What's this? Hold on. That's Wildcat Wendell Cooley.
I know I made some mistakes, man. I gave you back the money. Hey, Danny, I gave you back the money. I laid my title down for you, man. Just give me a chance. These men right here seem to have faith in your goodwill. All these wrestling fans out here seem to have faith in your goodwill. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. You're going to have to prove to me, you're going to have to earn yourself for me. If all these people got faith in me, and these men right here got faith in you, well, hell, I ain't going to be no different.
A highly emotional, highly charged scene.
Week continues now, and it looks like Wildcat Wendell Cooley and Nightmare Danny Davis will indeed be a tag team combination in the future in the Continental area, as we just saw in our feature match. Joe, Starcade is on its way.
That's right, Gordon. The largest event in the year for the NWA and the UWF will be taking place Thanksgiving Day in Chicago. It will be closed circuited to over 100 theaters around the country, and you'll want to check and see which theater in your area will be carrying Starcade. It's going to be a great afternoon of wrestling action. Number one, the match has been signed between Dusty Rhodes and Lex Luger, and some stipulations you won't believe. If Dusty Rhodes loses the match, he must retire from wrestling for 90 days worldwide, and that could be disaster for Dusty's career. Also at Starcade, a match announced this week, the Midnight Express and the Rock and Roll Express will get their chance at one another on a scaffold. And of course, Jim Cornette let it be known this week he was not very happy with that stipulation coming from Jim Crockett, but it will be a scaffold match, the Skywalker match between the Rock and Roll Express and the Midnight Express. And then, of course, we've heard about Terry Taylor stealing Nikita Koloff's belt. Jim Crockett, not very happy with the UWF and with John Ayers. He says they have not been effective in getting that belt back for Nikita. So at Starcade, there will be a unification match. Nikita will have an opportunity to get it back for himself. Now, that's what's happening at Starcade. We'll have more as we get closer to Thanksgiving each week right here in the NWA and the UWF update on pro wrestling this week. Right now, though, it's time to go back in time. Our Matt Classic is coming up next, Gordon.
And our Matt Classic this time takes place in the Hollywood Legion Stadium. The year is 1958. Don't adjust your TV sets now, because this is in black and white. We're going to be watching Mad Monty Ledoux as he takes on Pat McGill. Let's go back to 1958.
Bobby Coleman doing a wonderful job of refereeing out in that ring. Frenchman Into the ropes again. Watch this break. Elbow smash. Rabbit punch by Ledoux on the break. Boom. An over and under headlock. Here we go again. A drop kick to the chin. A vicious drop kick. Miguel misses. He really landed on his back. Runner. The knee drop. Another knee drop to the side of the chin. Bobby's pulling him away. Here comes Monty now, and there's an elbow. Body slam and a body press. One, two, three. Well, it goes down in the book as a body slam and a body press. But there was a case of a drop kick that backfired. Miguel missed, landed on his shoulders and neck. Monty softened him up with a couple of knee drops to the side of the chin and neck. Then he picked him up, and with a body slam and a body press, wins the match.
So Pat McGill misses a drop kick, and Mad Monty Ledoux uses the body slam to come out on top in our Mac Classic. Right now, let's see how the ladies do it. The ladies of POW, the WWA, we're going to see the terrorist as she goes up against that Irish beauty, Shannon O'Brien. Let's go now to David McLean and the ladies of POW.
She's gonna jump on her. This'll be it.
Oh, coming off those second ropes is the terrorist.
She hit her right in the solar plexus.
Shannon in trouble.
Yeah, that'll finish anybody, David. She's out. She's out on her.
And she goes for the chair. How can the referee allow this?
That's right. The referee stopped it in time. Good boy. Good referee, Jim. Jim got all of it. That's what it is. That's what it is. She's biting her, too, David. She just bit her.
There's Shannon's suffering, but she's not giving up. She's a tough little Irish girl.
Yeah, now she's...